Hello, veteran Owen Twin here, welcome back, and this is another episode of Final Fantasy VI. As you can see, I am on the solitary island. On this solitary island, we can fight really, really weak monsters. Land rays and peepers, they die, like, as soon as they act, or as soon as they get a turn. They have auto sap, and they only have, like, one HP each. And the interesting thing about that is you can actually finish battles really fast that way. Also, in this desert area here, you can encounter a black dragon. So if you want to fight him for experience, I guess you can do that too, but I'm not too worried about it here. Alright, yeah, these are the enemies right here. You can actually rare steal megalixirs from these land rays, and the rare steal for the peepers are elixirs. They have no common steel, so it is a lot harder to actually steal from these enemies as other enemies. Like, there is no, since there is no common steel, but there's a rare steel, it's a lot harder to steal. So, yeah, I'm gonna steal with Locke. Come on. Oh, and they all died before I could even steal, which stinks. So as you can see, the monsters are really, really easy to kill. I mean, because they pretty much die themselves. And yeah, with a preemptive strike right here, you get a good chance to steal. But it is a very low percentage. I've been able to steal about 12 to, I think, 13 megalixirs at this point. And they'll be useful. They'll be useful later on. Yep, as you can see, 13 megalixirs, so those are obviously really good. Yeah, I don't know how I don't know how many more battles I need to fight before powering up this damn shield, or before uncursing it, but it takes a long time. Even fighting these guys, it takes a long time to do. Come on, Shadow, yeah. Most of the time you can't steal, but if you can manage to steal from those guys, you get a megalixir. Also, those land rays will be useful later for... Oh, look at that! Dispelled Curse on Shield. I didn't know I was that close, but there we go. It is now the Paladin Shield. I'm going to go ahead and unequip that so we can take a look at it. Yep, best shield in the game. Wondrous shield that blocks a variety of attacks. Yeah, negates water, earth, wind, and poison. Absorbs fire, lightning, ice, and... Oh, wait. No, holy thunder, ice, and flame. Good defense, great magic evasion, great magic defense, and like I mentioned before, it teaches Ultima at times one. So again, if you equip the Paladin Shield on a character and then also equip them with the Ragnarok Esper, they will learn Ultima at times two because the effects are cumulative, or they stack. But yeah, it took me a long time to do that. While I was uncursing the Paladin Shield, I've been trying to learn magic with these characters here. But I'm not going to be taking these characters back to Narshe. So, yeah, I'll definitely want Mog in my party for the next part. Yeah, what I was going to say before the Paladin Shield became uncursed, those land rays will be important later on because we can actually teach a new lore to Strago. So, there you go. I'll be coming back here later. Alright, this is the party I'm going to go with right here. Yeah, I got Tara working on Phoenix for right now so she can get re-rays. That's the equipment I have for her. Pretty standard stuff for this point. Got the Valiant Knife Paladin Shield on lock, along with the Red Cap Force Armor, Ribbon, and Thief Bracer. And I got him working on Quetzali because I want him to have his Staga and Sloga. Yeah, I got Shadow working on utility spells like, you know, the shit that Fenrir teaches and other stuff like that. And then Mog, I don't really care about spells for him. I just got him stuck with Bismarck because he's going to gain a level the soonest, I believe. Otherwise, I wouldn't even have an Esper on him. You know, I forgot to do something. I forgot to equip Mog's relics. Or, wait a minute. No, I didn't. Then where was the jump command then? Very strange. Yeah, in the last battle, I didn't have the jump command. Where's the jump command, man? But yeah, these other doors that you supposedly can unlock, like the item shop, I don't believe there's anything in here. Oh, maybe you don't have to have them. Oh, okay, I guess you just have to have them in your party. I figured you had to have them in the lead, but I guess not. But yeah, there's nothing in there anyways, so don't bother. I got everything you can find. Yeah, I'll show this next battle, and there's no jump command. Where's jump? Where the hell is jump? What the fuckity? What the hell is going on? Is this like a fucking glitch or something? It's gotta be a glitch. Where's the jump command? Run away! Fuck, what's taking so long? They're just some pink wolves. What the fuck? No, I mean, I got... Oh, I have two dragon horns equipped. Wow, that explains it right there. Jeez. Oops. Wow, that's embarrassing. Yeah, I had two dragon horns equipped. Yeah, you need both. You need dragoon boots and dragon horn, not two dragon horns. That's not going to do anything for you. Alright, we should be good to go now. But yeah, I'll just have Mog take all these guys. He should be able to do it. Maybe throw a shuriken at this guy? I don't know. Steal? We steal anything from this? I guess we won't find out. Potions are worthless. Well, actually, I'm used to Edgar actually dishing out good damage. Yeah, he has much higher strength than Mog at this point because he's had the advantage of being around more and being able to take advantage of esper bonuses. Plus, he just has higher starting strength to begin with. I mean, I think he has like 37 starting strength, and then Mog has like 29, which is like, yeah, it's a big difference there. So if I get Mog's strength built up, then well, then he'll be pretty good too. But right now his strength is horrible compared to like some of the other characters. Oh yeah, Faraga, I learned that too. Actually, why don't I show off the flare spell? Goodbye. So yeah, this area is pretty much identical to what it was before. If you go up, it doesn't lead to anything. Yeah, you want Mog in your party for this next part here. Mainly because, if you want to learn his last dance, then you want him in your party for this upcoming part. Otherwise, I don't think he can learn it unless there's an area in the final dungeon that is snowy. Yeah, I'll show this one. But yeah, dances at this point in the game are, they're pointless. I mean, I like Mog for the floating continent because of Earth Blues, but other than that, I really don't give a shit about his dances. How are we doing on levels here? Alright, getting closer. Okay, I guess we're gonna get attacked in this area. Oh, I guess not. I guess we can get attacked in this area. So yeah, Mog's gonna learn a new dance at the end of this. Man, I have the Thief Knife on Shadow because, I like being able to do that better than I like instant killing enemies. I like being able to steal. Yeah, we get a new dance. Yay! Mog's final dance in the game. So yeah, there you go. That's all the dances he will ever get. My favorite one is this one, Earth Blues, because of that, that fucking rock slide attack is really good. I mean, it ignores defense, which I really, really like. Goss Perusa Rage is very, very much the same. Oh, there he is. Look at this guy, it's the Ice Dragon. This guy is weak to fire, as you can probably already tell. And yeah, he likes to freeze you. Luckily, you can just cast fire on that frozen person to heal them, or to get rid of the frozen status. No items. I didn't get to see what that guy had to steal, but yeah, this guy is toast. After you get Phoenix, learn Faraga. I like learning Faraga when powering up when I'm uncursing the Paladin Shield, because you can learn it fairly easily from the Phoenix Summon. And yeah, this guy is toast. Really easy. Alright, we get a Force Shield. 5 dragons remaining. Do I have a Force Shield at this point? I think that's my first one. Yeah, it has Water, Earth, Wind, Lightning, Ice, and Fire. It has really good magic evasion, and it teaches you Shell at times 5. The only thing that stinks about it, no defense. No defense or evasion, but as far as magic evasion and magic defense is concerned, this is probably the best shield in the game. I mean, overall, I think the Paladin Shield is the best, and the Aegis Shield is slightly below that, but that one's pretty good. Should I give it to somebody here? Terra, maybe? Yeah, because I don't really need the elemental protection. Although that brings down her evasion quite a bit, but her magic evasion is pretty high. Yeah, you know what? She doesn't need physical defense. At least, not right now. Yeah, I better save. Better to be safe than sorry. Remember this guy? Yeah, now he wants us to fight him, I guess. So that's what we're gonna do. Let's try attacking him. Let's see if, see if we can steal from him. Yeah, as you can see, this guy has really, really high physical defense. So I guess with Mog, he's going to be useless in this battle unless... unless I do something here. Mog, I guess he's just going to heal if necessary, but it won't be necessary. I'm just going to pound this guy with Faraga spells. If you have Flame Tongues, I believe those deal good damage as well. As you can see, Faraga definitely does the job. But yeah, the Valiant Knife works on this guy because it ignores defense. Yeah, I don't give a crap about your ice. Goodbye. So, humans broke my seal of ice. Humans who possess magistite. Just who are you? I suppose that's of little consequence. But what of this devastation that fills the air? What could the War of the Magi have lasted? Could the War of the Magi have lasted 1,000 years? That foolish, unending war, hmm? You would seek to put an end to it? Then I shall put my trust in you. Alright, so we get the Valigarmanda Magicite. And look at that! It opens up a secret passage. And it looks like I'm about... yeah, I got Zano Seeker on Terra, just in case the Bismarck here level carries over into her level as well from the next battle. But anyways, yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at this new Esper here. Yeah, you can learn Firaga, Blazaga, and Thundaga at times one. However, the best thing about this Esper, magic plus two at level up. And you can use an ability called Tri-Disaster that probably stinks. It's not very powerful. I don't know. Like, the Esper attacks in this game aren't very good. Like, the attack Espers like this one, like Hellfire with Ifrit, Diamond Dust, none of that stuff is really that good in this game. But, yeah, I guess I could have Terra work on that now, considering she'll get a plus two magic anyways from this one. She's done working on Zano Seeker. Sure, let's hop on in. Very interesting music they're playing here. Very, very interesting indeed. Let's take a look around after I take a little bit of a break. Actually, better yet, I'll just save going through this cave for the next episode. This is Veteran 0121. I'd like to thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.